Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nijja, a retired lecturer in hematology preaching Christianity and Sikhism. The other day I put a video that how fanatic these people are who are the moderators of Sikh Forum, Sikh Philosophy Network. What a sound name it is, and what a poor quality moderators are there. And I told them that you are blind people judging the other people. And they reacted very nicely. And they have just banned me forever not to enter into their network at all. So these bans I have from many of these blind to spirit moderators who are making people Sikhs of beard and turban. A Sikh stands for a student, and many times I repeated to them that a Sikh is a spiritual self, is not the physical self that is born and die, but they want to make it the physical self that is born and die. Remember these Jewish people at the time of Christ Jesus, especially of the Yuga tribe. They had become Jews of the physical body, not inwardly of the heart, but of the physical body of the circumcision. So after circumcising them, these rabbis, they were putting them in special clothing and making them to sit in front rows of the temple, whereas the Gentile used to be watching in the outer circle. So they were laughing at those people with the stiff neck and thinking they know more than anybody else, but they knew next to nothing, as Christ Jesus proclaimed. In the parable of the John 9, the born blind person, Christ Jesus amply reflected the blindness of those people. And they even did not believe that man who was cured of his blindness. So they called Jesus the son of Satan. And they themselves were as if they are saints, just the opposite. So these moderators from India and of Sikhism, they are far, far fanatic than the people of the Middle East, people of Judah tribe. So if you remember how when the temple was destroyed in 70 AD, how the people were, you know, dying of hunger and other things, and they were all facing towards the temple when they were dying. So much greater fanaticism is in India. So much so that they have broken all the records of the shame. They have no shame at all. The other day I had a person from India. She went there to Harmandir Sahib, which is the golden temple in Amritsar, replacement of the Jerusalem temple. And she told me, you know, that she went to one of their rooms where they have so-called the reading, and over there there were two people. One was saying prayer, the other was reading the book. So the one that she wanted to ask the man to say prayer for them. So he told her, put the money, don't put it in that golak, or we call it the chest, you know, put it beside the holy book. Don't put it there. But she happened to put it in the chest. And so he was not happy that she had put it there. What he wanted was the money. He wanted to pocket it in his own pocket, so that instead of going to the Harmandir Sahib fund, it will go into his pocket. So such malpractices are going on over there openly, but the blind to spirit people still have faith and they still go there. And the way they are being cheated is far, far greater than what the people were cheated in Jerusalem. So the destruction of this temple will be far, far greater than that which took place in 70 AD of the Jerusalem temple, which they cannot rebuild because the replacement exists in the Punjab, India, called Golden Temple. But what gold has to do with God? So she told me that after she had put that money in the chest, and another person came with a rod, and he stirred the thing so that every penny or every note goes down, is not showing up over there. And in these Sikh temples in all over the world, these greedy granthi or the priest, they devised a new method of taking money out from the donation chest. Even though the donation chests are made such a way that no straight thing can go in, but they put in a plastic tube which can bend, and they put the other end of the plastic tube to the vacuum cleaner. So what it was doing, the plastic tube was sucking money out of the chest and bringing it out for these greedy people. So most of these Sikh temples now, they have put up a video cameras at the place so that they can see the people stealing. And even if they are caught being stealing, they will just beg for pardon. And most of the people, they are so stupid, you know, that they will, let us forgive him, you know. And he will do it again, because this greedy man is not sealed to serve God, but sealed to serve Mammon. So he can't resist from his bad habit. So these practices, if you tell these fanatic forum people, look, these are happening, they will turn a blind eye, because they are behind these things too. They want people to be fleeced and cheated, not to be enlightened. They only know, as the Jewish people knew, that they had this the temple in Jerusalem, which was the holiest of holy. And so these Sikhs in India, they know this Akal Takht and Harmandir Sahib is the holiest of holy complex in the world. So the same Beth Sadapur is there, but the temple is standing in the middle of that Beth Sadapur. And I heard, you know, that the water of this pool will stir, and anybody who will enter into that one first will be cured of his physical ailments. So this pool is also the replacement of Beth Sadapur. And then this Jerusalem temple used to have a tower as symbol of the wine press. Remember the parable of wine press? So same power tower is there, which is known as Baba Atal. And that has a quite a high one. I think it is 7 story or so. So it can be seen quite far distance. So all these three things are there, but still people don't believe me. And the holies of holy book was got written by Satguru Arjan Dev Ji. It's highly corrupted.